energy than I've put into this show in the last 4 years. Thank you for that. Fun fact, that started as a slow clap, all right? That peaked just in time.
They built it up. Hopefully they have enough energy for us today.
You know what? These are for you. No, no, I'm giving them to you. No, you can't. This is for you. Including the clap.
Yes.
Hey, welcome to Attack of the Show, TV's only source for all the stuff you care about. I'm Kevin Pereira.
Yeah.
Thank you. Listen, Candace is out today, but that means it's Wednesday with Miss Morgan Webb.
Thank you very much. We are coming to you live from the D4 Studios in Los Angeles.
Hey, guess what?
What?
On the show today.
Is who?
Shanola Hampton.
Wow. Yeah.
She helped bring Left 4 Dead to life, and now she's on the drunkest show on TV. Not this one, Shameless. And today's Meme Watch stars, and we use that term lightly, Rebecca Black, the young California girl that might have ruined music and Fridays by opening her auto-tuned mouth.
And today's sneakerheads feature shoes that are pretty bad for sneaking, actually. We're going to look at a new pair of Adidas that glows in the dark.
What?
Criminals are already giving it a thumbs down. And then Adam Sessler is here to talk Crysis 2 in Game Break. Find out if this title could help usher in a new era of video games in which humans fight aliens.
What?
I know.
I've always wanted to explore that concept on a console
Very
game.
Very innovative.
That'd be so much fun.
All right, it's time now to run down the top 5 things on the web.
I think we're going around the net.
We are.
Okay. On Wednesdays.
All right. All right, let's talk about sports. I would like to...
Okay.
Come back.
I'm like, what?
We're not really going to talk about sports.
Okay, I was like,
much.
I'll Google something if I have to know it.
If athletes don't do sports very well, they usually end up in Around the Net.
Yes, and if you find yourself in Around the Net and R. Kelly's Ode to Soaring, I Believe I Can Fly, is playing ironically...
Oh, yeah.
You're lucky to be alive.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar.
No good can come from that. There was no good was going to come from that.
But he'll always have the best parking spots now.
That is true.
And you have one?
No, I'm just surprised that the guy who was kneeling over was fine.
Well, oh, yeah, I mean, he could have taken a knee or something like that.
Yeah.
But now he's going to be jealous his buddy's going to get all the good showers at the hotels. And,
that's true.
And he gets to write emails. He gets to write emails with a straw. I mean, that's something special.
That is a silver lining right there.
I'm a glass half full kind of guy.
I know you are. Let's talk about Rebecca Black for a little bit because
can we talk about sports instead?
No, we cannot.
All right, Rebecca Black.
Rebecca Black, she should need no introduction because despite being completely unknown just a few days ago, she is now incredibly famous.
She's everywhere. Her vapid pop anthem, Friday, is a serious contender for the worst song ever. It's been remixed mercilessly, but I think Brock's dub,
mm-hmm.
you know Brock,
mm-hmm.
of course, his is the best. Brock's is the best of the best.
7 a.m. waking up in the morning. Gotta be fresh, gotta go downstairs. Gotta have my bowl, gotta have cereal. Seeing everything, the time is going. Ticking on and on.
Everybody's rushing.
Gotta get down to the bus stop. Gotta catch my bus. I see my friends.
Hey, Rebecca.
Kicking in the front seat, sitting in the back.
Get the over here.
Gotta make my mind up. Which seat can I
take?
It's Friday. Gotta get down
this
on Friday.
This is freaking awesome.
Everybody's looking forward to the weekend.
And just a dolphin!
What?
That's what it sounds like with the auto-tune off.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I don't actually usually condone going after 13-year-old girls, but she attacked our ears first.
Yes. She is a living, screeching argument for the end of net neutrality.
Mm.
Truly. I can't wait. Her true Hollywood story is going to turn gray with dramatic music scenes when she's 15.
Yes.
You know what I mean? That's when it turns dark.
It's so sweet when you see them so young and innocent before and then during their train wreck.
There's no more innocence now. There's YouTube. There's no grace period. I can't forgive that crap. But I do yes. I do wonder if you remember a time of innocence.
A time of great innocence.
Then do you remember the time of American Gladiators?
The most innocent of all. Yeah. I mean, it's the best Saturday morning athletic competition show ever. I mean, of course I remember those times.
Well, Morgan, lucky for you, the comedy sketch troupe Summer of Tears just discovered a long-lost episode featuring one of the lesser-known gladiators.
Shelley is headed to the Conquer Ring to face our newest female gladiator, Rage.
Yeah! At home with my husband, I'm just a normal girl.
You'll never be a lady tonight. Let's keep the party going.
Watch out, America. I'm coming for you.
Shelley really needs this half a point, like Jim Henson needed penicillin.
Oh, and it seems Rage is being disqualified for unsportsmanlike conduct. Let's take a look at the replay.
Oh, yep, that'll do it.
I don't know, you guys. I mean, isn't putting a guy in drag just kind of a cheap joke?
Yep, sure is.
You didn't look half bad, though.
Thank you. I think. Everyone knows that teenagers and sex go together like serial killers and chainsaws, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that's okay. Something the ABC Family series, The Secret Life of an American Teenager, knows all too well. Our number two video is a supercut that shows how many times the word sex is used in one typical episode.
Yeah, how many times is that? The answer? A lot of times.
Sex. Even how sex-crazed teenagers can be, this actually seems surprisingly accurate.
Yeah, that's right, kids. I'm telling you, television is exactly the same as real life, except with more product placement and more sex, actually. Sorry, guys. Still ahead, though, we have a bone-shattering good time.
It's good.
Thanks to Steven Seagal.
Today's ATN featured a hooper ballist nailing a rim-rocking, spine-bending dunk. We have to see this team in action. So tell us, what's the name of the team that he plays for? Tweet us your responses at AOTS, hashtag OMGROFLOL. If your response brings the pain, we'll feature it on Friday's show.
Fail. Your dad. Major fail.
Fail.
Fail, 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 fail. You lose.
For the record, yeah. Sarah Underwood was not clapping. She will pay for that.
Oh!
Everybody else, be thankful, because today, around the net, the gods have really smiled upon us.
Yes.
Behold, a bounty of Steven Seagal clips.
Yay! We have been good. Before Seagal became a reality television lawman, he was known as an action movie badass of the highest degree. Mm-hmm. But instead of firing big guns like Schwarzenegger or Stallone, Seagal broke bad guys the old-fashioned way, with his bare hands.
Yeah. The crew at Film Drunk did the world a favor by compiling every bone snap from Seagal's mysteriously long film career.
Oh,
for that sound effect. I mean, that man has snapped over 100 human bones.
Yeah, well, if you count the number of Slim Jim snaps, yeah, that number is never ending. It's like it's like pie.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, Seagal is no stranger to pie as well. Big fan of math. To get your daily viral fix and to check out all the viral videos we have to offer, go to g4tv.com/aroundthenet. Guys. Excuse me, guys.
You're not touching it right.
Try a pinch and zoom.
Damn it!
What you guys doing?
Do you guys have the new iPad?
I've got to touch some oleophobic glass, man.
Oh, yeah, I know. I know what these guys are here for. I got it.
Those guys are friends of yours? I mean, the skinny jeans, I guess.
No. I mean, no, it's not. No. You're right. They do look awesome. But no, these aren't friends. These are clients, so to speak. Guys, you guys want to see a new iPad too, by any chance?
Yeah, iPad too.
Yeah, definitely.
You got one?
Definitely. Yeah, I might have one. Why don't you follow me over here?
Okay.
Let's go.
I'll follow you anywhere, man.
Morgan, I'll be right back. You see, due to equipment shortages in Asian markets, shipments of the new iPad have been delayed by weeks. But not for D-list celebrities like me. That's why I'm pimping out my iPad 2 at Kevin Pereira's Compassionate Tablet Caregivers. As soon as you get a recommendation from a medical professional, just come on down to our studio's green room and show your ID to our trustworthy security guard. How you doing, Frank? For a nominal fee, you can get your hands all over the iPad 2. Beat those shakes by attaching and removing the new fancy smart cover. Send an email with a signature, "sent from my iPad 2," so everyone thinks you bought one. Or write a song for your hipster collective musical experience with GarageBand. Okay, buddy, time's up.
But I didn't even finish looping in my John Cage sample.
Frank, we got a clinger.
No.
Frank.
No, I didn't even get to play Angry Birds. I'll do anything, Kevin.
No. Oh, God. No. No.
So if you need a tablet computing experience and your money's good, come on down to Kevin Pereira's Compassionate Tablet Caregivers. We'll be open until the supply chain is restored or the county decides to shut us down. So get here fast.
Kevin Pereira's Steve Jobs Angry Birds. Not valid in Delaware.
Call now.
Hey, do you smell that? Yeah, you do. Sunblock, bikinis, pools. You know what that is. It's spring break. But don't get caught in a pair of sandals. Check out these latest kicks. First up, time to whip out your lightsaber. The Holy Trilogy's resident bad guy, the Emperor, is getting his own pair of sneaks. As part of the continuing awesomeness that is their Star Wars line, Adidas has just released the ZX8000 Emperor sneakers. Made of black suede and mesh, these kicks are lined with brown leather and have the Dark Lord's mug pressed into the shoe's tongue. But the coolest details are the neon blue highlights that adorn the shoe in classic Force Lightning fashion. And guess what? They've got glow-in-the-dark soles. Perfect for anybody looking to take down a Jedi. Give in to the dark side and snag a pair of these Sith Lord sneakers over at ShoeU.com for $180. Now, going green for most people means planting trees or recycling. But for artist Gabriel DeShaw, it's all about taking garbage and creating these awesome sneaker sculptures. As part of his junk art project, DeShaw uses old typewriters and computers, along with discarded glass, plastic, and wood, to create these Nike masterpieces. The frame is made of metal mesh, with the sole and Nike swoosh built from old circuit boards. The shoes are then highlighted with various pieces of trash, like copper and loose keys, with the laces made out of braided steel. These metal kicks weigh anywhere from 5 to 18 pounds, so don't expect to get into any soccer matches with them. Each of these shoes are one of a kind and individually priced. To get the details on these junk dunks, head on over to GabrielDeShaw.com. And finally, we hope you don't have Cinderella envy, because you're going to be jealous with these see-through sneakers. Called the JS Wings Clear, these transparent kicks were created by fashion designer Jeremy Scott and were just released by Adidas. Made of clear vinyl, these high tops feature removable wings, have milky white soles and laces, and are finished with a textile lining for comfort.
Since these kicks are see-through, they will look different every time you wear them, depending upon what socks you have on, which means it's time to toss out all those ratty pairs. These shoes have already sold out on shopadidas.com, but you can still snag a pair on eBay for about $190. So there it is. Sneaker sculptures, see-through shoes, and Star Wars kicks. We're not saying sandals are bad, but really, does anyone want to see your toes?
Why am I doing this again?
You're welcome.
Can you get an intern for this or something?
Yeah, we do have interns for this.
Yeah. This isn't my job.
Well, you know. It works.
Still ahead. Chris Gore does not sexually harass the cast.
Don't, still ahead already? I'm enjoying. Just take your time. What?
On camera, at least.
Oh, later, Shameless star Shanola Hampton. It's all right. It's all right. Get in there, man.
She's going to
don't
be
hurt
here
your hand on this.
Live in studio. Now, I'm going to set up for you.
No.
Yeah.
No, 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 no. Don't go to break. Don't go to break. We like this shot.
Here's a question for you. Would you cut off your own pinky with a rusty knife for free booze for life? Well, you logged on to G4TV.com and told us what you thought, and we'll have the results after the break.
Yeah, live.
Wait, you?
Wow, that is strange, because usually on the show we stab each other in the back.
Oh! The results are in, and about 27% of you said that you actually would cut off your own pinky with a rusty knife for free booze for life. Too bad the deal doesn't come with a tetanus shot. Log on to G4TV.com for more questions like this and tell us just how far you can go.
When we have free stuff for you guys, we don't kid around.
No, it is time for an epic giveaway.
Okay.
It was very epic.
And by the way, Sarah Underwood's still not clapping.
I'm clapping, Kevin!
Incredibly rude.
I've
seen
clapping.
Some rude things in my day, but...
You're going to earn yourself another massage. He's a liar.
Look at that reluctant face. On Monday, we were actually giving away a life-changing amount of Dungeons & Dragons books and games, courtesy of Wizards of the Coast.
And the lucky Dungeon Master is Daniel H. of Bloomfield, New York. Congratulations!
Well done. Well played.
And now today, we're making more nerd dreams come true. One viewer will win a gigantic Venture Brothers collection, courtesy of Adult Swim.
Included is every episode of the Venture Brothers on DVD and Blu-ray, Venture Brothers action figures, bobbleheads, music from the show, a Venture Brothers wardrobe, and much more. Plus, if that wasn't enough...
That's not enough.
You're also going to get... This
ta-da.
Award-winning plastic phone. Old set.
To okay. enter, visit our website.
Place.
I mean, it's not just any award, it's first place.
It's first place. It's
absolutely.
The award.
It's worth more. Visit our website, gport.com/epic giveaway. Get your entry in between now and March 24th by 3 p.m. Eastern to be eligible. We're going to announce the winner right here on tomorrow's show. Kevin's, it's going to be hard for him to let go of that phone, but he's going to do it.
It's actually
you.
Not that hard. Really, I already broke it in half, and
okay.
There we go.
Here at Attack, we care about memes so that you don't have to. Yes.
What's the latest online thing that people can't stop mocking?
What's that?
I'll find out right now in Meme Watch.
Do you ever have trouble remembering the days of the week? Well, luckily for you, a new meme is here to help you remember forever. In less than 3 weeks, the video for Rebecca Black's song Friday has reached well over 38 million views and skyrocketed to become one of the world's most watched videos of all time. Still racking up an average 3 million views a day, the song is an overnight sensation that has put the 13-year-old aspiring singer into the limelight and inspired hundreds of covers, parodies, and remixes. It all started with a company called Arc Music Factory, an LA-based record label that recruits new young singers and produces them to become viral hits. In fact, they've done so in the past with moderate success. Their video for Kaya's Can't Get You Out of My Mind reached over 1 million hits. You got me thinking of you. And Alana Lee's Butterflies got more than 2.5 million views. But no one expected Rebecca Black to break out like Bieber. Friday was written and produced by the ARC team, while the video was shot on a $2,000 budget funded by Rebecca's parents. However, the responses online have been all but endearing. The combination of mundane lyrics and auto-tune has pulled in a lot of scorn and laughter from the web, including comments like, "Tell me this isn't real," and "That was the most miserable 4 minutes of my life." But aside from the onslaught of cyberbullies and being a top trending topic on Twitter, Friday has also done some good for the world. Yes, it's inspired hundreds of parodies.
Jones Day, I'm only gonna do it Jones way.
From acoustic covers and Bob Dylan tributes.
Gotta catch my bus. I see my friends.
To dubstep remixes and death metal versions. Friday has effectively stolen all of the attention from Charlie Sheen and created a downward spiral of satiric sequels and hilarious dubovers.
Partying, partying.
Yes.
Partying, partying.
Yeah.
Our favorite parody prize has to go to Matt Mulholland for his emotional tour de force that brings out a very dark and twisted side of the pop song.
It's Friday, Friday, gotta get down on Friday.
At the rate this video is racking up the views, it's projected that it will surpass Justin Bieber's Baby as the most watched video of all time. There's no denying that Friday is an internet sensation, and whether you love it or you hate it, it's not going anywhere.
We can. Friday, Friday. You sound just like her.
I know.
And so Katy Perry at the same time. Let's visit with the Twitter Wall.
Hey, Twitter Wall.
First, we have Temecula. Temecula says, sex lists, bones breaking, and technology junkies. Great way to start out my first time watching Attack of the Show. Welcome, welcome. And yes, it is always this awesome.
Yeah. And you'll constantly lie about watching us to your friends. It's okay.
No, I never heard of it. I don't watch that trash.
We understand. It's all right.
It's all right. We're ashamed too. Let's see. It's pronounced NC says, why won't Sarah clap? The world is a darker place because she won't clap.
She
hashtag must, my hand is a dolphin.
She must not know that. I mean, every time she does that, an angel gets their wings.
Oh, okay.
Happy?
Like, you just served me. Like, yeah. All right. What's up? Two dolphins slapping together.
That is really all he wants out of life.
That's it.
Validation, external validation.
Hey, if you guys want to be a part of the show and end up on our Twitter wall, tweet us. At AOTS or use the hashtag AOTS.
Yes.
I think that'll do for the Twitter for now.
We're done with it.
Okay.
All right, well, we should educate ourselves. And here to help us do that, Miss Sarah Underwood. Thanks, guys. Right now it's time to start the beep.
All the news you need to know.
It's Wednesday, March 23rd, and here are your top stories. Netflix is having a bad day. Never mind the reports of major service outages last night. Showtime is pulling a bunch of its shows from Netflix Instant. So has the exodus begun? The premium channel said they'll be pulling some of their content from Netflix's streaming service, including Californication and Say It Ain't So, Dexter, when their deal expires this summer? No! The decision is reportedly in response to Netflix becoming an increasing threat to premium cable channels after announcing their plans to move into big-budget original programming. There are rumors that other cable channels may follow Showtime's lead, so let's hope Netflix's new show is really frackin' good. I said frackin', not the other one. Starbucks may not be your favorite place to hang out, but that might change thanks to what they're adding to their free Wi-Fi. Those poaching the coffee house's complimentary Wi-Fi will now have subscription-level access to ESPN Insider and the full Marvel Comics Unlimited library. Yeah! Oh, yeah, and the Wall Street Journal and The Economist. But who cares? Marvel Comics Unlimited, bitches! Yeah! If you end up seeing Blair Butler's face on the side of a milk carton, you'll know where to find her. And finally, the Nintendo 3DS officially hit store shelves Saturday at midnight. Yay! Yes, and this retail camper is ready for it. The man who calls himself Triforce was recently caught on video outside a Manhattan Best Buy, and apparently he's been there since Monday. Triforce says he was the first in line for local Wii and DS launches and said it's all in the name of tradition and maybe some free stuff and media attention too. Triforce, we here at Attack the Show would like to wish you luck on your endeavor and losing your virginity. It's gonna happen for you someday, I'm sure of it, someday. Oh, by the way, the new Captain America trailer arrives tomorrow. Do you guys want a sneak peek?
Yeah.
Do you want one?
Yeah.
Okay, here you go.
Your enemy is not what you expect.
Whoa! That was it? Okay, I'm Sarah Everwood, and you've just been fed. Now back to these guys. Yay! It was a very, very sneaky peek.
That was a real sneak.
It was a real peek. All right, this Friday, America's gonna get sucker punch.
Watch out! Chris Gore sat down with the cast and director of the trippy action fantasy to learn about life in a mental institution. Hmm. Not that he knows anything about that intimately or anything like that.
Of course not.
No, not Gore.
From director Zack Snyder, the powerhouse behind 300 and Watchmen, comes Sucker Punch. It's part fairy tale, part tragedy, but all action, with a story that begins with a girl named Baby Doll. But don't let her innocent looks fool you.
There's really intense material. I mean, it's almost like I would describe the movie as like guns and tears.
You know, the movie started out as an R-rated movie, you know, and then when we went to make it, I'm like, you know, it should be PG-13, because if it's not, it's just going to be about the hard stuff that I'm going to put in this movie. And so I really wanted to back off of that and go, like, let's go after this little bit of this drama and make this dark, dark movie and see if we can get this PG-13 thing to work within the confines of that. And it really was a big challenge.
Is it fair to say this is nerd porn in a way?
Yeah, it is like a feast for people who love like modern myths and like understanding different like video game terminologies. And like, you know, we have a completely different understanding of ourselves because of our identity in like a digital world, regardless of whether you're like a nerdy 14-year-old boy or, you know, like a really distinguished 50-year-old gentleman.
Or if you're a nerdy 14-year-old boy in the body of an older gentleman.
And that happens more often than not. I think I have a nerdy 14-year-old boy inside of me. It's crazy.
In this movie, visually, it's even more intense and ambitious, I feel, than 300 and Watchmen.
I mean, it was super intricate to plan, but I had definitely these ideas for these action sequences I wanted to lay out, and then in the sort of making of them, we really went down the rabbit hole, as they say, into like a crazy world, so it was good fun.
The action in this movie is over the top.
We trained for a month in Los Angeles and 2 months in Vancouver. We started off our mornings 3 hours mixed martial arts with the stunt guys and the stunt coordinators. And then we'd have a little break, have a protein shake, have some vitamins. Then we'd train with the personal trainers who were Navy SEALs, and we'd do some gun work, maybe a bit of wire work.
I'm interested in creating images that make people go, you know what, I gotta go to the theater and check that out. Like, I can't wait for DVD or Blu-ray or whatever. And even more, I want them to say, like, I need to go to IMAX and see that, because I need it to blow my mind even more.
In terms of the costumes, say if I wanted to get my lady friend to dress in similar type of outfit, what could I do to get her into those kind of clothes?
Well, that's...
That's really between you and your lady friend, I think.
You pull it off so well.
I don't know, have you tried it yet? I feel like it's a whole session we need here.
Yeah.
I'm willing. Well, let's go.
Let's go. All right, so what are you done?
Please number describe one. In detail some of the costumes that you want for your lady friend.
Oh, I'll do whatever. Pleather pants.
What a bad boy, Chris. Wow. Okay.
If it gets too hairy, if I say it's over, we stop.
Sucker Punch is like a swift kick right in the nuts. But it actually kind of feels good.
Sucker Punch!
I would like to say, call attention for all of you herbal supplement enthusiasts.
What? Go on. Oh, I get it.
G4 is celebrating Pot Day this April 20th on 420, which is Police Speak for Pot in Progress.
Oh, yeah. There's 420 episodes of Cops,
yes.
Which is basically an episode of Cops.
All of the Cops episodes, yes.
We have a special herbal attack of the show, mm-hmm. And even a 420-themed episode of X-Play, yep. And Web Soup.
Yep.
Isn't that crazy? Log on to g4tv.com/420 for more details. Don't worry, we will not be glorifying pot.
Absolutely.
We will not be celebrating marijuana.
Absolutely
we wouldn't do
not.
That.
That would
it's
be wrong.
It's a medicine, you Absolutely. Jerks.
After the break, Shanola Hampton will talk Shameless.
Yes, and Left 4 Dead.
Yes.
Stick around. We should not leave machine guns in the green room.
Did you know that Kevin and Candace are both ninja assassins?
Is this something you read on the attack message boards?
No. It's because they kill me with comedy every week night at 7.
This was a total waste of my time. I will just save money on car insurance instead.
Come on. Let the joke sink in. I'm so lonely.
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The show Shameless isn't just about being poor and drunk. It's about being poor, drunk, and having a complicated sex life.
You think Steve's just lying?
Probably.
If I find out he is, I'm done with him.
Done with who?
Steve. He's getting text messages from some bitch named Candace.
Candace? Uh-oh. That sounds like a woman you have an affair with.
It does?
No, please. That fool doesn't have enough game to cheat. Did you ask him if he was?
Yeah, he said he wasn't.
Well, then you have two choices. Believe him or don't.
Or you could let your suspicions grow until you turn into the Ice Queen and act like he's invisible until he starts sending anonymous threatening notes and you have to report his ass to the popo.
Please welcome Shanola Hampton, everybody.
Hey!
Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
How are you?
So amazing. How are
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I'm half as amazing.
Just half?
Well, I aspire to be as amazing as you.
Amazingly fantabulous.
You came in here like a whirlwind of fresh air and positive attitude.
Yay!
And then I'm like, apparently this show hasn't brought you down yet.
No, but I love this show.
We're gonna do our best. Let's talk Shameless because Emmy was here not too long ago, and I had asked like, hey, did you realize what you were getting into with the whole fact that there really is no wardrobe department because you guys don't wear any?
Yeah.
I want to ask the same. Were you aware going into this that it was going to be a very adult show?
Yeah, I knew it was going to be very adult, and this audition process was really, really crazy. It's about 7 auditions, and like every single audition, our director Mark was like, so you know. You're going to actually have to be, what do they say in America? Because he's pretty, ironing topless.
Oh.
A whole scene. I was like, oh, okay, that's fine. He's like, you're going to be okay with that. I was like, yeah, sure, I'll be fine ironing topless.
Right.
Yeah.
And obviously he has trouble asking.
Yeah, I see.
I.
Yeah.
I want it. Will any of the test footage be on the DVD? Will that be an extra?
I didn't actually have to do it in the audition.
Okay, that's what I was
saying. So that was good.
Good.
Yes,
good.
Yes. No, I didn't have to. I mean, I would have to get the job. It's a great job.
I iron topless for our president every day. Just in his office.
That's
and
how
believe
you got the job.
I will fluff and fold to keep a live show. Like nobody's business. You have the, I want to talk Left 4 Dead.
Yes.
Because you were the face of a character in Left 4 Dead 2. Rochelle, but you were more than just the face. You were the entire model. You played the whole.
I did. It was a great process. That was something that I've never done before. It's like training for that. I went to graduate school of University of Illinois, so I got like stage combat stuff, but this was totally different. They like take pictures of you doing crazy faces. You know, just these, I'm like, really? And it's hours of you again. It's terrible. And then the whole time I was like, so when do I get to do the gun? Where's the gun? Where's the gun?
Yeah,
I know
yeah.
I get a gun. And they're like, the gun is coming, the gun is coming. And I'm on the little thing and I'm going around and they're like, and then finally I get the gun.
Okay.
And I'm killing the zombies, baby!
I bet everybody breathed a sigh of relief once you were holding the automatic rifle on the set. So now, do they give you any direction? Do they cover your face in the tracking dots or anything like that?
No,
or do
they don't
just,
do that.
Just photos?
You just, yes, and there's like these mirror things that are one up here, and one down here, and then they kind of, you're like in this thing.
So you look like a Lady Gaga stage show.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
And do they say, all right, now you're being eaten by a zombie. Now someone's exploding on you. Now,
yes.
Like, and you just run through
and
it?
And then you just do the faces like that, and I gave good face, baby.
Yeah. Oh,
I'm Rochelle. Okay.
We have played. We've seen Rochelle. Now, tell me about these guns, though. Like, I know you did stage combat training, but have you been trained with firearms?
No, I never actually owned a gun myself, but I always loved guns. I don't know what it is, something sexy about a girl with a big gun. That's what was so great about Rochelle, like this girl with the gun and shooting the zombies. And so I actually did one when I was going into a birthday. I went to a shooting range. And I
feel like I'm supposed to ask something else, but I don't know. Just keep going,
please. Are you on with the big guy and the girl?
The last thing I want to do is interrupt this train.
But no, it's just like one of those things that I loved. And when I was the first time I actually held a real gun was when I was going into a birthday and I wanted to go out with a bang. So I was like, I want the biggest gun you have.
Yeah.
And he was like, you can't handle the biggest gun I have. And I was like, I can absolutely handle
the
biggest gun.
Then the pizza delivery guy showed up on this dialogue. Because this is again, I don't think you can handle that firearm.
I don't think you can handle that.
No, I got it. So what did they give you a giant weapon?
They gave me the big weapon and I took it and I had it right here and I just went boom.
Yeah.
And I hit the wall. I did.
It physically blasted
you
back?
Yeah, well, I didn't know that there was a backlash like that. Well,
yeah.
But there's definitely a backlash.
That's something they could have told you before they had you pull the trigger.
I think he was trying to. I don't listen well.
Do you do other extreme stuff, or is it just guns and shirtless ironing?
For my job, I do the shirtless ironing. And, anyway.
just right in the middle of the laundromat.
Just sometimes.
Hey, everybody.
Hey, guys. You need something folded? I got you. No, the most extreme that I do is watch hours and hours of television. I'm really a TV-aholic. I don't drink or smoke, so my addiction is television.
Really?
And sweets.
Okay, but what's on the DVR? Are you just constantly, do you watch anything that's on?
I'd watch a lot of trash television, but I love Glee because I'm a musical theater girl.
Of course.
So I love Glee. I love Modern Family. I love Outsourced.
You haven't mentioned any trash TV yet. I'm assuming the G4 watermark's got to be burnt into the corner.
G4 is not trash. It's the best show out there. G4, baby.
Yeah! I think we'll take it. Shinola, awesome. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
You are 10 pounds of awesome.
Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you.
Shinola Hampton, everybody. You can catch her in the season finale of Shameless this Sunday night on Showtime. Yeah. Now, coming up, it's Adam Sessler versus Crisis 2 in Game Break. And the game moves. That's just a spill.
No, it's fine. This is normal day at the office.
Yeah, exactly.
You are huge.
That's pretty massive.
Coming up tomorrow on an all-new Attack of the Show. Director extraordinaire Zack Snyder will sucker punch his way into the studio live. Then Morgan Webb heads to CTIA and goes hands-on with the cell phones of tomorrow, including the Sony Ericsson Xperia Play. And what's up with the world? Well, how about the pole dancing championships and a ban on public farting? See it tomorrow. All right, it's time for Crisis Talks. Here comes Game Break. Welcome back, X-Plays Adam Sessler!
So these are the new stools I've been hearing so much
about.
Welcome
to them, yeah. They've been arc welded. You can't move whatsoever.
It's also been made for like a 21st century butt.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
This is for those old stools.
This is for Jetson taint right here. This is all the future, everybody. Speaking of future, let's talk Crysis. Obviously, the original was known for basically a graphical benchmark for your PC.
Right.
It was for nerd bragging rights.
It was for the 15 people that had some type of rig that could actually play to optimal settings.
Right. My machine can actually run this game. Is it fun? I said it can run it. That's about it.
I finally was able to run it 2 months ago.
Really?
Yeah, so I started playing it.
That's
so I'm
telling.
Like, what's all this Crysis talk from 2008?
Well, here we're looking at Crysis 2. Obviously, it's a gorgeous looking game.
Yes.
But, I mean, how does it compare to the first?
It's definitely not this jungle. It's also not set up in the same way as the first one, where the whole conceit of the original Crysis is you're on this island, and while you have to go to a certain place, you had a lot of variety in terms of the path
you
could
take. It's incredibly open.
This is a little bit more constrained. Like it's more linear in going from one place to the next. But within these environments, because it's not just jungle, and there's this verticality from these destroyed buildings, it offers a lot more variety in the moment instead of that just that open space for open space.
Right. So it's a first-person shooter, which, I mean, I'm supposed to ask, how's the story? Does anybody care? Let me get right to that.
I think if you're one of the 15 people to play Crysis, you're going to care. Now, they have constructed this story assuming that most people haven't played it. You don't play a character from the first, but you're mistaken for a character from the first, so you are as confused as the character that's in the game.
Fantastic.
It's a story, you know, aliens, they've attacked New York. New York is destroyed. There's clearly some conspiracy. There's a good story there, but I wouldn't say the storytelling is that compulsive or gripping that's going to be the selling
point. But again, it's an FPS, so no one's really going to care at the end of the day if the story makes no sense. It's all about this power armor or having this crazy bodysuit
yes.
that can have different abilities, right?
This is the biggest improvement from the first one. In the original Crisis, you kind of had a wheel, like a Ratchet and Clank kind of wheel. Mm-hmm. Like, okay, I have to select this. Here, each of your powers is assigned to an actual button. And so you can really feel more comfortable just using it whenever you want to.
Right, on the fly, going invisible, switching to right. armor if you're going to take some damage.
And what's neat is that there's an energy bar. You can only use one of these powers for a certain length of time. So it's not like I'm just going to cloak for a while.
Right.
You have to plan your attack and then use those powers very quickly and very effectively to make it happen. And when you do, it really is a power fantasy.
I got killed a lot.
Yes.
I mean, a lot. And I fancy myself a moderately decent first-person shooter player.
I think it's because it is not... If your playstyle is like a Call of Duty playstyle, it does not work with
right,
this.
No,
and it took me about a good hour to really get accustomed to how you're supposed to sort of survey the battlefield, pay attention to like the cues you're getting. Mm-hmm. And then when you do it right, it is like, ooh, I feel special.
Right. And now, what about multiplayer, though? Because when I went online, it was basically, oh, everybody's invisible, and I'm dead.
Right.
Like, that was the extent of my experience.
Well, I would say multiplayer, as with most of my multiplayer experiences, is about as much fun as junior high school because that's what you're playing with.
Right. But the actual mechanics itself, I mean, the people that are playing aside, if you're playing with a group of friends, is it fun or is it sort of wash, rinse, repeat, this is multiplayer, we get it?
I mean, I feel that this game, its selling point is this rather remarkable graphical powerhouse that's in that story. But as with all games, it has to have some multiplayer. Maybe it'll take off. It probably won't.
Right. Another thing, they... big sticker on the back of the box is that it's 3D ready, that it
yes.
can be played in 3D.
I have not seen it in 3D because I don't have a 3D TV because I'm part of Planet Earth. what I've heard from those who are somewhere out there with their 3D TVs, that it is probably the most impressive use of 3D because you're in that mask.
Right. So that
really
HUD is probably up in your
yeah,
face.
Yeah, it's really playing off of a sense of how you might actually be seeing it if you're in this awesome suit.
All right. So bottom line, did you enjoy it? What is X-Play giving it?
It's a 4 out of 5. I think it's yeah! one of the stronger shooters. At least there's way too many shooters this year. This is one of the best ones of the first half.
All right. Good to hear it. Thank right. you. Adam Sessler, everybody. Yeah! Crisis 2 is in stores now. Thanks for being here. Good stuff.
No problem.
Good to see you.
I would like to give a big thanks to Shanola Hampton, Adam Sessler, and especially to me for co-hosting, you know. Sarah? Oh. Stick around because Campus PD starts right now.
You've just been to bed.
Sarah, help me. Any help?
What?
You do kind of look
I kind of look like the girl from the American Gladiators video.
You do.
I can't.
Really do. Good night.
All right, everybody.